The impacts of a crisis can be staggering. Lost lives, damaged properties, wasted economic opportunities. Extreme weather events have made natural disasters more severe. They set back social and economic growth. Poverty worsens. How can people effectively confront crisis? The International Labor Organization established that creating jobs and developing skills help people cope with calamities. Through the Employment Intensive Investment Program, it established that active participation of communities and use of local resources truly works. In Dolores, Eastern Samar, residents formed a Rural Workers Association and identified flooding as a problem that has to be solved, as it also brings cystosomiasis, a life-threatening disease. With local government assistance, they built a clean and covered concrete-lined canal, creating decent and productive work in the process.
So this partnership between the end users, the local government, the ILO, the province, is a very, very, very good sample of community involvement. And if we can duplicate this in other municipalities, this would be an example of government and civilian participation.
But the benefits went beyond merely providing work to people. The members of the community acquired practical skills in carpentry, masonry, and small contract management.
Na ngailangan ng pagsasanay at dumaan sa iba't ibang proseso ang mga community associations bago sila naging contractors. Kailangang magkaroon sila ng legal personality pag re-register nila sa isang government agency. Sa Department of Labor and Employment, pwede silang mag-register as a rural workers association.
In Iloilo City, the organization introduced job creation tools in disaster-prone communities. In one village, the residents experienced difficulty in reaching the main road because of a muddy and slippery footpath. They decided to construct a concrete walkway to solve the problem. The improved pathwalk led to better access to social and economic services.
Since the community, the Porok Albasia Dwellers Association, is the contractor, members themselves were the ones who were hired to work on the project.
The same transformation occurred in another village. They constructed a concrete-covered canal and footpath to the main road. Clearly, decent and productive work for all men and women is essential to reduce poverty. Restoring damaged infrastructures creates jobs, develop skills. And for this to succeed, cooperation between government and its citizens must be realized.